As we progress, we know Bishop is a family of ours. He's here with us every month, you know, sharing with us the great things that are happening in Kansas City Junction, as well as, you know, sharing a great message and great thought about how God is efficient and how we can move forward in our Christian life. So Bishop, go ahead and say hi to the audience today. This is 2020. Go ahead, Bishop.
Hello to everyone. We're so happy to be here. We're so happy to be in a new year, and we thank God for what he's doing and how he's blessing. We're just proud to be on AR Record TV Network, and we're just so happy to have God in our life, leading and guiding and uplifting the ministry that we have, and keeping us and helping us to do the things that will glorify him and that will bless the people.
Amen, amen. So Bishop, you know, Christmas, you know, passed, and the New Year's, and how is the weather down there in Kansas City, Georgia? Because it's been a little warm here, but you know, we get the change here. So how's the weather down there? Talk to us a little bit about that.
Well, the weather down here has been snow and cold.
Oh, okay.
So cold. We just had snow yesterday, but it melted today.
Okay.
And it's raining now.
Okay.
But it's about 30 something degrees today. But the day before, it was down in the 18s and 19. It was cold.
Amen, amen. Well, at least you're in the heat with family and sheltered, and you know the most important thing, that you're healthy. You know, you receive 2020 victory, and that's the most important
amen.
Thing.
Amen.
So, any testimonies about what's happening down there? What happened over the holidays? Go ahead, Bishop.
Well, we just thank God that we were all able to go through the holidays. Nobody was sick, and we were able to just glorify God and just praise his name and thank him the time that we had together with family.
And you know, not so much the time that we had together with family, but the most important thing, that you know, we're healthy and you know, everybody is doing well over there. I'm happy to hear that over here the same. You know, we can say that, you know, it was a great you know, experience to you know introduce a new century. You know, 2020, that's a new century. It's like we talk about vision, about you know when you go get tested for your eyes, you know, that you got, if you have a 2020, you got a perfect vision, you know. So but this is a special year, and we are definitely glad, you know, that everything is going well over there. First shout out to the First Lady Johnson as well. So, you know, we gave her first shout out. So, but no, we do appreciate, you know, God blessing and you know what God is doing. In what we are producing right now, our network is growing. We do have different programming over the whole day. So everything has changed. So we have movies, we have other shows. We actually network with a network up in Florida as well. So we shoot some of the programming and stuff like that. So, but God is blessing, and that we're trying to move and take this to another level. But we know God is good and God is great. But today we have a great topic, Bishop. We're going to be talking about the talents. Okay, so we're going to be talking about that today. And I know that's going to be a great topic for those who are listening, those who are going to be listening on the radio, those who are watching on the network. And you know, but let me give you some good news. In the event, now we're pre-recording today, but in the event, we're going to go live, and your picture going to be on the screen now, Bishop. We have everything set up for that now, so we're just still testing and working on that. But in the next few weeks, we'll be live. As soon as we're doing our show, we'll be live again. So, but that way, the audience will be able to watch us live, and so it'll be more of a live thing. But in the event, we're still pre-recording and editing and putting it out, and it goes, you know, a few times over the day, over the weeks, over the month. So, you know, we are glad that we are able to have this service and be able to, you know, get this message out, because the whole idea about this is to getting the message out. But Bishop, go ahead and lead us in prayer as we get started today. Go ahead, Bishop.
Father, as we go into this new year,
yes, Lord.
We prepare our hearts and our minds,
yes,
Lord, we just ask you now, everyone that you are blessed with a gift or a talent,
yes,
let that music, yes, for your glory and your honor.
Yes.
God, you are the one that's blessing us. You,
yes,
are the one that gives us everything.
Yes,
and so,
Lord,
God, we just want to give back to you.
Yes,
we
want
to lift you in everything that we have.
Hallelujah.
We want to give it to you.
We thank
give
you,
it
Jesus.
Back to the kingdom.
Yes.
Give it to your people, that yes. they may be blessed and that you may be glorified.
Yes,
so,
Lord.
Father, as we go through this today,
yes.
as we talk with each other and talk with the radio audience yes. and those that are listening today, let
yes,
them
Lord.
Hear a word, God, that will
Hallelujah.
Encourage, that will lift, that will let them
yes,
know
Lord.
That you love them. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Bishop. But today we're going to be talking about the talents. And we want to encourage people out there who, you know, have a vision of doing something, who aspire to do something, you know, to hold on to that vision, keep that dream alive, and, you know, move forward and believe and trust God. Because, you know, if you trust God and you believe God, that God is going to work out, you know, a great open doors and work out, you know, the situation. So a dream that you're trying to accomplish may be accomplished. So let's talk a little bit, Bishop. But before we do that, I'm going to read the scripture on Matthew chapter 25, verse 14 through the 30th. But I'm going to just go through, you know, a couple areas so that way we can, you know, have a discussion, you know, about what we're going to be talking today. It says that it is unfortunate that this it's called, and when we look at the parables of the talents, it's something that we want to look and we want to see progressively, and we want to see how effective, you know, God is and how effective God work to be able to help us accomplish, you know, everything that, you know, we strive to. Okay, so let's look at the progression of this. So I'm gonna start out with Matthew chapter 25, verse 19 through 21. Okay, let's look at we're gonna look first at you know, that the first progression of the five talent. Okay, and one of the statements that is said is, well done, good and faithful slave, you were faithful with a few things, and I will put you in charge over many things, to enter into the joy of your master. So, Bishop, let's just introduce by talking about what is a talent and what is expected of an individual that do have a talent. Go ahead, Bishop.
When God gives you a talent, it could be a musician, it could be playing, singing, whatever gift he has given you, that talent he has given you, he wants you to use it for his kingdom. Because when we look at this story, he gave one five, gave one two, and gave one. So when he gave them all, he expected to receive more than what he gave them. And that's what God is looking to us for. When he gives us something to use for his glory and for his kingdom, he expecting us not to bury it, but to use it for his glory and his honor.
And when we're talking, when we're using it for his glory and his honor, and, you know, we're looking up saying, you know what, this is the expectation of, you know, how God is effective. And when we're talking about parables, for the people that don't know what is a parable, parable is what we call short stories. And a short story is how Jesus used to communicate with the disciples, because he was so intellectual, to make them understand, to make them know, to make them have a better perspective of how, you know, he wanted them to learn the teaching and how they can put that teaching in practice. But when we look at the 25th chapter, let's talk about the parable of the 10 virgins first. So it says, at the time, the kingdom of heaven will be like 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out and meet the bridegroom. Five of them were foolish and five were wise. The foolish one took their lamps, but did not take any oil with them. The wise one, however, took oil in their jars along with their lamps. The kingdom was a long time in coming, the bridegroom was a long time in coming, and they all became drowsy and fell asleep. At the midnight, the cry rang out, "Here's the groom, come out and meet him." And then all the virgins woke up and trembled their lamps. And the foolish one said to the wise ones, "Give us some of your oil, or lamps are going out." And they said, "No," they replied, "there may not be enough for both of us and you. Instead, go to those who sell oil and buy some for yourself." So what we're talking about, the introduction of this, because then we're going to go back into those talents. But Bishop, let's talk a little bit about, you know, how, you know, Jesus introduces these 10 virgins, and he said, you know, this is what's going to be happening. You know, the bridegroom is coming. You know, you got to get ready, get your lamps, bring it, you know. But the whole perspective of this is, the question is, when we have these talents and when we are seeking something, what should be the road for preparation to be able to allow this talent to expand and to grow? Go ahead, Bishop.
Amen. And that's what God is looking forward for us through his son, Jesus, for us to grow and for us to become better, for us to be more like Jesus in our everyday life.
Amen.
And while we are walking this journey, he wants us to stay focused on the one that called us on the journey, so that we'll know the way, because Jesus is the way. And when he gives us something to use, a talent, a gift, or whatever he may give us, he wants us to use it so he can be glorified, but we also will be blessed.
And not so much the blessing, but, you know, people got to understand that there is a process for preparation, because, you know, we do want to accomplish something. And when we're talking about give, we're talking about something that's, it's a gift, something that is given. You know, not everybody have it, but it's given to specific individuals, to people. And sometimes you might not have that gift, but you can develop that gift, because sometimes God give you a gift, but you got to develop that gift. But one of the things I want people to understand and people to look at is that, you know, there were preparations. So the wise virgins were prepared for the long journey that was coming forward. And the foolish ones were not ready because they didn't take enough oil. So one thing that we as individuals, and we and Christians, and, you know, individuals that we do anything that we do, the most important thing is that we keep that fire burning. You know what I'm saying, Bishop? When we keep that fire burning, not only in the church of God, but we keep that fire burning in what we believe in. Because, matter of fact, I was talking to somebody who's trying to go into boxing and stuff, and I was telling him, the first thing that you have to do is you got to believe in what you're doing. If you believe in what you're doing, bigger doors going to be open. If you believe in what you're doing, you're going to accomplish what you need to accomplish, because that fire is going to be burning. So the wise one knew that there was going to be lack of oil in case the extended time came, but they were prepared and they was ready. So, Bishop, let's talk a little bit about preparation. Go ahead, Bishop.
When we think about preparation, you preparing for what may come ahead. They were preparing. If they had it to wait, they would still have oil. We are preparing for what we have to go through in life.
Amen.
Through the word of God. We are preparing ourselves to face each day with the challenges that comes through that day. We'll be prepared to deal with that day according to the word of God, and whatever the word of God tells us, we can do, because God is back in his word.
And not only that, when we look at John 3:16, he said, "For God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." So which means that, hey, no matter what we do, and we center our goals, or we center our life, and we center in giving God the glory in what we do, we know that expectations are going to be high, you know, doors going to be open. But the most important thing is that we understand that we're going to keep that fire burning. Bishop, the question now is, people who are going into ministry, let's talk a little bit about the ministry side. How can we encourage people to sustain the ministry regardless of whatever is happening? Go ahead, Bishop.
When you go into ministry, ministry is a call.
Amen.
By God.
Amen.
And you got to make sure that he's calling you into ministry. Watching other people from the outside don't let you know what's going on in the inside, the inner working of ministry. Ministry is a thing that, let me tell you, it's not easy all the time. It may look like it is, but it's not easy. But God will give you everything you need to be able to minister to the people, and everyone is not going to accept what you're ministering. But yet still, you got to know who called you to ministry.
Amen.
And that's who you're doing it for.
And one thing people got to understand is that, you know, when we go to ministry, like you said, the first thing is the calling. And then the second thing is the preparation, because we got to prepare spiritually, we got to prepare mentally, we got to prepare throughout, you know, with the theory, we got to prepare in different angles. But sometimes God calls us, like, you know, and the most important thing and what I like about God, when God calls us, it don't make a difference what you know, who you are, what, it just make a difference that he wants to use you. And that's the thing that people need to understand. In this case, God wanted to use the wise virgins because he knew that they were going to perseverance. And when we're talking about perseverance, we're talking about no matter what may happen in the ministry, good and the bad, you're going to support that ministry. You're going to stay faithful to God because you know that in the midst of that perseverance, God is going to open, he's going to give you the victory. Sometimes the victory may not come how you expect the victory is going to come, but the most important thing is when you persevere, because the wise virgin, they persevere because they said, you know what, we're going to need oil, we're going to need extra oil, and we're going to be able to be ready for the bridegroom when he comes. The bridegroom came and then he welcomed them because they were ready. The light was shining. And one thing I want people to understand is that when your light shine, he said, let your light shine before man. And when your light shine, the glory of God is going to shine on you because he knows that you are his chosen individual and you have been called. But let's talk about that perseverance. Bishop, you got 40 years in ministry. So talk about perseverance. What do you think have helped you or have helped you and your wife and the family to persevere into the ministry that you got right now? Go ahead.
The thing that helped me to persevere is that I have to remind myself I didn't call myself into ministry. Mm-hmm. It was God called me into ministry. When I say, yes, Lord, he said, now I'll give you everything you need to do ministry. And now, sometimes as we go through over these years, you get weak. But then you turn back to the one that have made you who you are, who called you to be who you are, who strengthened you in the time of need, and let you know, I got you, and I can carry you through this situation, and I'll give you the power. And then also we have to remember in ministry, we don't rely on ourselves. We rely on the Spirit of God that he has given each individual. He's given us his Holy Spirit. The Spirit is the one that does the ministry through you. You put the Word of God in you, and the Holy Spirit will bring it back to you.
And not only the Holy Spirit is going to bring it to you, but the Holy Spirit is going to give you the direction. That's why Paul said, you know, in a book of Acts, that when you receive the power of the Holy Ghost, because that's the other thing we got to seek, Bishop. Once we are preparing, once we are praying, once we're seeking the power of the Holy Spirit, he said, once you receive the power of the Holy Spirit, then you shall be witness. And when he said witness, he said your light going to shine, which means that you're going to go anywhere, and that light, that Spirit of God that's in you is going to shine, and it's going to move in a very unique way and in a very persistent way. So, Bishop, let's just direct ourselves real quick to the parables of the talent, because we're talking about the talent. So that we're talking about, you know how you take those talents and how you got the persistency, and now in the midst of that talent, you're gonna say, you know, this is what I want to do. This is how I need to accomplish it. But Matthew chapter 25 verse 14 says, for it will be like a man going out on a journey who called his servant and entrusted to them his property. He said, the one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, and to another 1, to each accordingly to his ability. And let's stop right there, Bishop. Let's look at this real quick. We're talking about talent. We're talking about perseverance. But the Bible clearly said he gave them the talent in accordance to their what? Ability. One, he gave 5, 2, and 1. So, Bishop, let's talk about ability. What do you think about when we're talking about ability and when we're talking about the ministry? Go ahead, Bishop.
When you look at ministry, sometimes people look at those people on TV who have got 10,000 members, 25,000 members. Some people got 200 members, 50 members. Mm-hmm. He gives to each individual according to their ability. I look at the ministry that I have and I say, God, I thank you for what you have given me according to my ability. Now, I don't worry about those other people that have those big ministries. I'm a faithful witness and a faithful servant over what God has given me. That's what, when you deal with the talent, each one, except for one, was faithful over what he gave them according to their ability. The one that had five had the ability to deal with five. The one that had two had the ability to deal with two. The one that had one didn't do anything with it. He may have the ability, but he still didn't do anything.
Amen.
God is looking at us with expectation, saying, what I give you and what I put you over, I know you have the ability to do what needs to be done because I gave it to you.
And not only that God gave it to you, but God knows that you are able to endure. And one thing that, you know, we know and the Bible clearly teaches us is that God will not give us a trial, a test that he knows that we are unable to carry any burden. And one thing I want to encourage people who are out there in the ministry, because this is the thing, Bishop, is it's easy to start, but it's hard to persist. And that's the whole situation about everything. And the Bible said when the master came out and entrusted, he said he entrusted, which means I believe in what you're doing. I am going to give it to you. I know there's no set answer, but I'm going to give it to you. And he said he entrusted him, which means he gave him confidence and said, I'm going to give you these. But the Bible said that the one that had five went and traded five and got five more. And that's what we got to understand, is that when we have and when we believe in what we have, we're going to go out there and seek what God has in store for us, because we believe in what we're doing. Because what happened, the fire is burning, and when we have the Holy Spirit, that fire is going to burn. Because there are times when we become discouraged, right or wrong. It's like when God told Moses to go to Pharaoh and say, Pharaoh, go to Pharaoh and tell him to let my people go. Think about it this way. I mean, he went down there, and the Bible say that when he went down there, he said, I come in the name of Almighty God. And then he said, you know, Moses took the rod and threw it on the ground, and it turned into serpent. And then, you know, Pharaoh said, you know what, well, we can do the same thing. You know, that's what people got to understand. You know, the devil can do the same thing. But let's look at this. He said, because remember, God entrusted Moses. He said, you are going to go there and tell him I say this. And the good thing about the whole thing is that, yeah, Pharaoh did the same thing. The people who did the magic and all that did the same thing. They threw their rods and they were two serpents. But the Bible said that the serpent of Moses ate those two other serpents. So which means, yeah, that God has power over every power, authority over every authority, and the, yeah, devil is a liar, because what God has for you is for you. Hallelujah. And one thing we got to believe and we got to understand is that, hey, we have these talents and we have to keep working. You know, Moses did not give up when he saw, you know, those magic people threw the rats. He could have stood there and say, oh my goodness, oh, they did the same thing. But he said, no, I'm going to believe God. And the question is, because remember, God entrusted us. He gives us, he say, I'm giving you this ministry. I'm entrusting you this. It could be singing. It could be preaching. It could be being, you know, anything that God gives you. Because sometimes, we see, this is one thing Bishop, I always learn this, and I taught this, and I preach this in the church, is that everybody believe that the big ministry is just for the one who out there with the microphone preaching. That's not just part of the ministry. Part of the ministry is when you can go out there and have a one-on-one with somebody and talk to them and lead them to Jesus and bring them to the church. That's a ministry. So people don't know, you got the ministry of being an evangelist. You got, but you know, the problem is that everybody want to look good in the front, Bishop, you know what I'm saying? And nobody want to do the other little things. Like sometimes, I mean, and I know there are people in the church that will clean the church and happy about that little job they got, because they believe in what they're doing. God have entrusted them to do that. And the Bible says, if you're faithful over few, what he said, he want to make you ruler over many. And one thing I got to say, that Moses was very concise of what he was doing, and he said, I am going because I know that God has entrusted me this ministry. So Bishop, we're talking about entrustment, we're talking about God believing in you. So what can you tell the individuals out there that are working with what they got, what they should do? Go ahead, Bishop.
Always remember who gave you the ministry. Always remember who called you to salvation. See, we have to go back sometime down memory lane and remind ourselves that it wasn't us that brought us. It wasn't us that kept us. It was God that brought us and kept us. It was God that called us through his son Jesus. He did it all so that people could get to know him. So don't think with that mindset, look at that person that's out there over 500, and I'm just talking to two. If everyone would reach one, what this world would be like today. And we have to realize, God say, when one, in the Bible, it's when one soul come, the angels in heaven rejoice because one come. And that's the thing we have to look at. When we can win a soul to the kingdom of God and in the family of God, we all can rejoice. So we have to realize that God is the one that's working in us, through us, to draw others, not to us, but draw them to him.
Amen. And let's move on. I mean, as we go through, because, you know, I'm going piece by piece. But then it says right here in verse 16, and it said, who had received the five talents went once and trade with them, and he made five talents more. And he said, so also he also who gave two talents made two talents more. But he said, but the one who had received the one talent went and dug in the ground and his master's money. I say, now after a long time, the master of those servants came to settle the account with them. And he who had received five talents came forward bringing five talents more, saying, master, you delivered me five talents, and here I have made five more. His master said unto him, well done, good and faithful servant. If you have been faithful over little, I will set you over much. Enter into the joy of your master. And he also who had two talents came forward saying, master, you delivered me two talents here, and I have made two talents more. His master said unto him, well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful over little, and I will set you over much. Enter into the joy of your master. And he also who had received the one talent came forward saying, okay, master, I knew you to be a hard man, reaping where you did not sow, and gathering what you scattered no seed. So I was afraid, and I went and hid your talent in the ground. Here you have what is yours. But the master answered unto him. But let's stop right there, Bishop, because, you know, this is the thing I want to get to, okay? The one that had one, he buried it. Bishop, you know when you bury something, you ain't going to see it again. He buried his talent. And one thing I want people to know and understand out there, that no matter how you think that whatever God has given you to do, that is nothing, is insignificant. I want to encourage you to take it and not bury it, but go out there and work at it. Because if you work at it, like he said, if you're faithful over few, he will make a ruler over many. So, Bishop, let's look at the concept of burying what God has given us. Go ahead, Bishop.
One thing we have to realize, there's nothing that God can give you that's insignificant. Everything that God gives you has a purpose in his plan of salvation for this world. So we have to realize, when we don't use what God has given us and we bury it, that's not pleasing to the Father, because he gave it to you, and he didn't give it to you not to use it.
Amen.
So for everyone that's listening, if God have blessed you with a talent, use it for the glory of God. If God have called you to just reach one, reach that one. Whatever he's calling you to do in this world, on the journey, which we call salvation, do it to the glory of God. And don't do it feeling down and frustrated. Mm-hmm. Do it rejoicing, knowing who you are doing it for. I'm doing it for God.
And Bishop, you know what? I look up the definition for the word, well, actually the Hebrew word for buried. And in Hebrew, the word is quake. It's a little bit hard to pronounce, but it's kavar. No, quavar. That's what it says, quavar. And it says, the origin of this word, okay, bury, which means have buried, okay, And it talks about making people understand that once you're buried, it's over. There's no life in it. And if we take that, it's called kovar. That's how the Hebrew word kovar. And we take that Hebrew word and we don't do anything about that. We're not specifically open our hearts, open our minds, and saying, you know what? This is what we're going to do with this. I'm not going to kovar it, which means to bury it. I'm going to take this talent and I'm going to make it shine. Because the problem is this: when it's buried, there's nothing you could do with it. You can't uncave it. It's done. But God want to encourage somebody out there that has a little talent, that has a little ministry, and you're trying to give up. God want to encourage you and say to you, do not bury your talent. Go out there and continue to work, because if you continue to work, God is going to open bigger doors. And one thing I want people to know and understand is that the Bible clearly says, if you're faithful over few, he will make you ruler over many. He clearly said to them, come and enter. But the problem with this, Bishop, is that nobody wants to start from the bottom. Everybody wants to start from the top. And you cannot start from the top. You got to start from the bottom, because God got to train you. God got to grind you. God got to work with you. God got to give you the desire. God got to change your ways so you'll be able to handle what's going to come with all that victory that you're going to receive. Because this is the thing, Bishop. You know, we are public figures right now. And with the internet, everything you do, people criticize. If you do something, they criticize. Yeah, if you do that. But the whole thing about this whole thing is that, are we ready to take the pressure? Are we ready to handle what's coming, you know, our way? Are we ready to support what's coming our way? Because sometimes, you know, people want to be star singing. People want to do this. People want to do that. But there is a price to pay when you have all these things that come. And you're surrounded. But like you said, he's not going to give you a burden that you are unable to carry. So the most important thing that we got to make people know and understand is that you cannot bury that talent. It's not about the big thing you do. It's about what you do and how you give the glory and the honor to God. Bishop, talk about giving the honor and the glory to God. Go ahead, Bishop.
When we realize everything in heaven is giving God the glory, the honor, and the praise. Even the things on the earth, the birds, the trees, everything that God created except for humanity.
Amen.
Though he had to send his son to die to buy us back, so we'll understand it wasn't us, it was him doing it all the time for us, keeping us when we didn't even know him. So we have to realize one thing. God loves us so much. He gave everything. And then he bought us back. And then he gave us the ministry that we have. And he said, now I want you to use it for my glory so that I can get dividend or fruit from your labor.
Amen. And go ahead, Bishop. Keep going.
That's why we have to go head on. Because God said, I didn't buy you back just for you to sit and do nothing, but I bought you back so you can go out there and help somebody else to get to know me so they can be reconciled to me. It's a never-ending circle. Bring them and bring them to Christ. They go out and win another. Bring them to Christ. The kingdom of God is always growing. Because somebody is always hearing the good news and realizing there's a way out of their situation.
And not so much that there's a way out for the situation, but there's a way to really know and understand, you know, how the effectiveness of God is going to be, how we as individuals are going to be able to accomplish the goal, how we as individuals are going to be able to fight this battle. Because we got battles that we got to fight. But the Bible says that we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. And one thing I want people to understand is that whatever we are doing, we have to ask God for his strength. Whatever we are doing, we got to ask God for the guidance. Whatever we are doing, we got to ask God to help us move forward. I remember, Bishop, almost 40 years ago when I started playing the saxophone. Okay, you know, I started, like, you know, I went actually, it's a long story, but I'll make it short. But actually, started playing the trumpet because there was one was a trumpet player that came to our church when I was young, very young, at 10, I was 11, and he came and played that trumpet at the church. My mom was a bitch, so he invited me, he played the trumpet, and I was so blown up. So I said one day I want to play the trumpet. So I had to make a decision. I said, when, you know, through grade, going into my, you know, being 12 years old, between, you know, doing a practice dance or going into the band of into music. So, you know, unfortunately, I talked to my mom. I said, "Mom, what's your take?" She said, "Whatever you want to do, you could do." So I went into, I dropped the other stuff. I went into music. So, like I said, I'm gonna make this the long story short. But the whole thing was that I started playing the trumpet, and there was one trumpet, and there was two of us coming to fight for the trumpet. As soon as the school day were over, we were there running to try to see who was gonna get that trumpet. And I remember one day, me and the other dude was gonna get into an, we got into an argument. So the band director came over. And he said, "Listen, I'm going to do something." He said, he told the other kid, "Look, you're going to stay with the trumpet." And he said to me, "You're going to get another instrument." So I was like, you know, Bishop, you know, I was like sad. But one thing I want to say, the Bible said, "All things work for good to them that love the Lord." Yeah. And, you know, if I would have sit there and said, "Well, I'm not going to do nothing because I want the trumpet. I need that trumpet. That's what I want to play." But eventually, the band director that day, he went into the band room and he grabbed a bigger case. He grabbed a saxophone, an alto saxophone. He said, "Okay, you're going to play this instrument." And I'm going to say this to you, Bishop. I mean, I'm thankful to God that I was not an individual who was more of, you know what, this is what I need to do. Because what happens is this. When you get that one talent, you're just stubborn. "Oh, I'm not going to do nothing with it." But I said to myself, I said, "Listen, okay, hey, you know what, I'm going to just play this thing." And fortunately, when I start playing it, I did so well that in less than 6 months, I was already playing with the whole band. I mean, I was playing in, you know, the third section, but I was already playing in my first concert at age 12, going on 13. And then the funniest thing is that, you know, as time went by, I kept playing in church and I kept doing events and stuff like that, playing, you know, background tracks from other artists. But one thing I could not do, I could read music, but I could not play by ear. And I'll never forget this, that there was a couple missionaries from Uruguay who came to Panama. And at that time, you know, they came and they were, you know, they came and they preached in the church. I mean, they were so talented because the father of the preacher, the son of the preacher at that time, could play every instrument. So I said to him, the thing is that they came over to the house just for, you know, dinner and stuff. And, you know, after a while, you know, we ate dinner and then we was worship, you know, we just start talking and then we start singing. And then the guy said, I will never forget that night, Bishop. I'm going to be honest. I don't know what came over me that night, but he said to me, he said, "Listen, you got your saxophone?" I said, "Yeah, it's in the room." But he said, "Bring it." I said to him, "I can't," he said, I can't play by ear." I said, "I can read music, but I cannot play by ear." He said, "Listen, just go bring the saxophone." So I went out there and I was not stubborn. Remember, Bishop, if I would be stubborn and say, "No, this," and put some excuses, and I said, "I'm not going to do this." So, but, you know, in the midst of everything, he came out, he had a big accordion. He took the accordion and they had the guitar, and I brought the sax. And Bishop, I don't know what happened. We started singing, and after that night, I could play anything by ear. Believe what I tell you. After that night, I could play everything by ear. And then, you know, when I went to college, I took piano lessons and stuff, so I'm able to play almost every instrument. But what I'm trying to say is that we cannot stay fit in what we see. We got to grab the other option. The other option was to do that. I said, "Okay, I'm going to do it." And not complain about it, but be faithful of what we're doing and just live with the expectation of what God is going to do. And I'm glad that I did that. It was not close-minded, because let me tell you something, Bishop. When we act like that individual that had the one talent, we become close-minded. And when you become close-minded, you are not thinking about what God can do through that. You are thinking about what you see at the moment. And the same thing happened. It's like when Jesus had to feed the 5,000 men and women, you know, the kid came with the bread and the loaves. And think about it. If we were in a secular minded disciple, look at him and say, "Well, what are we going to do with these, these two fishes and the 5 loaves of bread? What are we going to do?" But Jesus said, "Do not worry." And he prayed for it. So what I'm trying to say to people out there, you use what you have. Pray over it and let God do the rest. That's what I want people to know. Because I'm going to say this, is that, you know, it's easy to give up because we give up. I was an individual that every little trial, I give up. I will not fight. I give up. I let it go. But I learned over time that if I fight, I fight and I let God fight with me, I'm going to receive the victory. I am going to be powerful. I am going to do what God wants me to do, because it's not by power, it's not by might, but the Bible says it's by my spirit. Hallelujah. Yeah, so if I do it in the spirit of God, I know that I will reap the verse that says in John 3:16, the Lord, Psalms 23, the Lord is my shepherd and I shall not want. I get too excited here, Bishop, but I want people to know that there is victory. Perseverance, there's victory. Open your eyes, open your eyes to the bigger things, and let God do what God want to do. Talk about that, Bishop. Let God do what God want to do. Go ahead, Bishop, go ahead.
That's the thing, when we realize who we are, who God is. Just like this man right here, I'm looking at this story with the talent. He said, you're a hard man, reaping where thou hast not sown. And then he came and he said, I was afraid. If we quit making excuses and start realizing God didn't call us to make excuses, because he don't give us nothing that he hasn't prepared us or he hasn't qualified us to be able to do. So what we got to do is go forward and do what God has called us to do. So what we need to do is go forward and allow God to be God and lead us. If we follow him, he will lead us in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. He will keep us when we're in the valley of the shadow of death. He will make a way out of no way. He will be our Jehovah Jireh, our provider. Because God said, that's how much I love you. And I want to show you that I'm your God and there's nothing that I will withhold from you.
And when you talk about nothing that I want to withhold from you, it's like, he said, faithful and good servant. Faithful and good servant. Enter. Faithful and good servant. So when we do what we have to do, we're going to receive those greetings. And, you know, let me go back to this real quick. I want to go back to, you know, when we're talking about, you know, he definitely took that and he buried it. And one thing I want people to know and understand is that God loves you. And God is going to support you in anything that we do. But, you know, this is the word he said. He said right here in verse, in the 25th verse, okay. He says, so I was afraid. You know that word afraid, Bishop. That word afraid, he says, I was afraid and I went and hid what you have given me. So that's the word, afraid. So Bishop, let's talk to people about being afraid. Because the problem is this, and it's logic, because, you know, sometimes we don't step out by faith, you know? What the Bible says, faith is what? It's substance of things that we do not see, okay? And when we, this is the thing, and this is the word that really, when I analyze the scripture, I really look at it, because afraid is a big deal, right or wrong?
It is.
Go ahead, Bishop. Go ahead.
The Bible says, I have not given you the spirit of fear again to bondage. Fear puts you in bondage. It brings on torment. And God said, I haven't given you that spirit. The spirit I've given you is that you can. Not you can. You can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. You can do what I call you to do. Why? Because I put my spirit in you and I anointed you and I called you, I qualified you to do the work that I called you to do. So we don't have to be afraid in God about anything as long as we do it his will.
And you say clearly, his will. But the key thing is, you know, when you're afraid, you don't do anything. It's like when the Philistines were afraid, you know, they were afraid. David, you know, the Philistines had, you know, the people of Israel afraid. But David said, I am going to go fight Goliath. And what Saul said, no, you can't find this guy, you know, you little, right or wrong. But he said, I am not going to be afraid. I'm going to take the step of faith. Listen, Bishop, I'm gonna tell you this, and you know, and you can talk stories. I know you have a great testimony with the ministry and how you guys, you know, started that ministry and how God blessed everything. But it's about stepping out by faith. And one thing I want anybody out there to know, step out by faith. Because if you step out by faith, God is going to make a way. Do not be afraid, because if you're afraid, you're going to take the talent and you're going to hide it there and nothing is going to happen. Because what happens is, in all honesty, we do become discouraged, because discouragement comes, you know, in everywhere, every shape, every form, and we are human beings. But I want people to know, and I want people to understand, is that, you know, we are humans, but we have somebody up there that loves us, that take care of us, and that's going to be with us, and that's going to help us receive the victory. And if we would have taken that talent, Bishop, that little talent, and he would have exercise it, let other people know, I know God was going to do something with it. Think about it. When God called you to the ministry, you didn't say, oh, I'm not going to do this. You can say, I'm going to step out by faith. Right around, Bishop.
Amen.
And when
Amen.
You step out by faith, tell the people what happened. Go ahead, because I know you got, tell them what happened when you step out by faith. Go ahead.
When you step out by faith, see, you got to realize who called you to do what you're doing. When you realize who called you to do what you're doing, then you can step out by faith and believe that if he called you, he's going to give you everything you need to do what you need to do. When we first started this ministry, we stepped out on faith. We believe God before we even see it. Praise God, come together like it is right now. We believe God and say, okay, God, if this is your ministry, and we just want to be the one that under shepherd to lead it and do what you want us to do, that you may get the glory in this ministry, and that the people who come in this church may be blessed by your word and grow and become stronger. And that's the thing, what the ministry is all about, allowing God to do what God does and you doing what you're supposed to do. I don't want to get in God's lane and he don't get in my lane. He always say, I got you, and I'll show you what to do, but now you got to do it, and I'll give you everything you need to do it. And he hasn't failed us yet. He hasn't failed this ministry, and we have done everything that we needed to do, and we are growing, and God is blessing.
And you know what, Bishop, this is the whole question about this thing, is, you know, believing God. Because when we believe God, God allow us to do great things. David believed in God. Moses believed in God. And through their faith, believing in what they had to do, they received the victory. The people of Israel were delivered. Goliath was defeated. And Israelites were free. But one thing I want people to know and understand is that God loves you. And God, if God has placed this gift in your heart, this gift is giving it to you, just use it for his glory. But use it wisely. And make sure that he takes care of what he wants to take care of. So you, as a vessel, because we are vessels, Bishop, we don't receive the honor and the glory. The honor and the glory belongs to God. And we're able to know this. We don't receive honor. We don't receive glory. And I want to say, you know, we're talking about talent and we're talking about faith. I mean, this TV ministry has been a ministry that we step out by faith, Bishop. I'm telling you. But God has opened the door, and is opening the door, and is working the situation out. And we have stepped out by faith. And we want those who are watching us, who are listening on the radio, to pray for this ministry, to pray for Air Records TV Network, to pray for Bishop Ministry over in Kansas City, and to pray for all ministry around the world. Because when a minister step out, he step out by faith, believing God. So, Bishop, what are your final thoughts today? Go ahead, Bishop.
You know, I want to say this on faith. I'm going to Hebrew 11 and 1, but I want to read it in the New Living Translation. It said, faith is the confidence that what we hope for will actually happen. Mm-hmm. It gives us the assurance about things we cannot see. And that's what we got to realize. If we see it, we don't need faith to get it. Amen. But when we can't see it, and we believe God for it, and it's lining up with his word, we can have that assurance that it will come to pass. The men in the Bible that had the five, the two, and the one, those that had the five believed God. Those that had the two believed God. The one that had the one didn't have enough faith in God that he would help him to multiply that one so he would have two. And that's the thing we got to believe God for. If God gave it to me, he'll give me what I need to multiply what he has given me.
And Bishop, this is what we want to leave people with today, is that no matter how big your talent is, no matter how what you have to do for the work of God, or what you got to do out there, do it with love. Do it because you know that the one that's going to give you the prize is the man up there, God who's up in heaven. So Bishop, let's take a minute. Let's pray for the audience. Let's pray for all those who are watching us all over the world, you know, listening to us. You know, we want people to know how great God is. So Bishop, go ahead and pray. Go ahead, Bishop.
Father, right now,
yes,
for
Lord.
Everyone that have gifts and
yes,
talents
yes, Lord.
That you have given to
yes,
God,
yes, Lord.
God, don't let them hide.
Yes, yes.
But Lord, let them use it for your glory
yes,
and your honor.
Jesus, yes,
God,
Lord.
Let them know
yes.
that you bless them.
Yes.
Now we bless others with what you have blessed us with.
Yes,
so
Jesus.
Father, right now,
hallelujah.
You touch the hearts of everyone
hallelujah.
That's listening, God,
hallelujah.
To our record TV
yes,
network.
Lord.
So they'll know, God,
hallelujah.
That we love you,
yes.
and we just want to tell them about how
hallelujah.
good you are and what you can
yes,
do.
Jesus.
God, Dr. Swab,
yes,
and his family,
yes.
you just wrap them in your
yes.
arms and
yes.
keep them and help him to
yes,
continue
Lord.
To go forth
hallelujah.
And do this ministry
yes,
that
Jesus.
May be glorified.
Yes, Lord.
Father, I thank
in
you
the name
for
of
what
Jesus.
You're doing for the people
in the
you
name
are
of
touching,
Jesus.
For
in
giving
the name
him
of
the
Jesus.
Heart and the mind
thank
and
you,
the
Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
To want to go forth
yes, Lord.
And bring forth
yes.
this program
yes. Yes.
that people lives may
hallelujah.
be changed. I thank
yes,
you, God.
Lord. Yes.
I give you all glory and
yes.
praise for that
hallelujah.
Man, God,
yes, Lord.
who mm. is moving
yes,
forward.
Yes,
say,
Lord.
God, I can't
hallelujah,
you.
Hallelujah.
But God, you get the glory in everything
yes,
I
Jesus,
need.
Hallelujah.
I will not lift myself
yes,
up
my Lord. Yes,
I
my Lord.
Done, but I'll
in the name
keep
of Jesus.
Up say, Lord,
in the name of Jesus.
In my sight
yes,
what
Lord.
You have done
yes, Lord.
In my life. In
hallelujah.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And amen.
Lord, we thank you for Bishop. We thank you for what you are doing down in our ministry. We thank you for what you're doing, Lord, for us, Lord, in this telecast, Lord. We thank you for what you're doing through the radio as well, Father. And we thank you because we know that as we come the day as one praying in one accord, that we know that you are able to move and bless those individuals out there. And Father, we know that there's somebody who is watching or listening that needs encouragement regarding what God has call them to do regarding that talent that they have, and we want to encourage them, but we want to pray with them that God may give them the wisdom, the knowledge and understanding for them to know how effective God is and to know what God is going to do and how God is going to move in a very unique way. And Father, we know that it's not by power, that it's not by might, but it's by your Holy Spirit, Lord. And
yes.
Father, we ask you, Lord, that you may multiply, Lord, whatever they're doing, Father. Father, bless that ministry up in Kansas City. Let nothing be, let them not be wanted of anything. Father, bless this ministry here as we keep moving, and we keep opening doors, and we keep preaching the word, as we keep letting others know how great you are, because we know that you are not going to fail or forsake us, but you're going to be with us, Lord. And Father, you said we are faithful over few. You shall make us ruler over many, over a lot, Lord. And we're not doing it because we want any prizes. We're doing it because we love you. We do this because we care. We do this because we love the souls. We do this because we know how effective you are. We do this because we know that in the good and the bad, you're going to give us the strength. In the good and the bad, you're going to support us. In the good and the bad, you're going to make a way out of no way. And Father, we thank you because we know that you have not forsaken us. Father, we claim victory for the world. We claim victory for everything that we do. We claim victory for your power. And if there's somebody out there who don't know you as the personal Savior, we ask that you may touch them right now. And they
right
may
now.
Come to your feet. And they may acknowledge that you are the Lord of Lords and King of Kings, Lord. And Father, we worship you. We thank you. And we adore you. In your holy name, we pray and we thank you. Amen. And
amen.
But Bishop, before you go, we're gonna start doing this because there's somebody who's watching us, and they might not know about how to come to the feet of Jesus, and we want them to know that the only way that you can come is by acknowledging that you're a sinner and by confessing that he is the Lord of Lords. So Bishop, let's do this. You know, anybody out there and you want to come to Jesus, Bishop, I want you to lead them into the way to come into Jesus. Go ahead, Bishop.
right now, if this program has touched your heart,
yes,
and you don't know the Lord in the pardon of your sins,
yes,
He has bought and paid for this day through His Son Jesus Christ,
yes, Lord,
that you may get to know Him as,
yes,
your personal,
yes, Lord.
So as I pray,
hallelujah,
this prayer, I want you to pray it with me. Lord Jesus,
yes, Lord, yes, Jesus,
I believe that you are real.
We believe, Lord, that you're
real. I believe that you died for my sin.
That you died for the sin.
I believe that you're sitting on the right hand of the Father,
yes,
making,
Lord,
intercession,
yes,
for,
Lord,
me. So forgive me, Lord,
yes,
of everything
me.
That I have
everything,
done.
Everything, Lord.
And Lord, come into my heart.
Come into my heart.
And make me one of you.
And make me one of
God,
you.
God, I want to make you Lord and Savior of my life.
Make you Lord and Savior.
I claim you as my Lord and Savior.
I claim you
and
as my
I
Lord.
And I claim your salvation in
claim
Jesus'
salvation.
Name. And I claim it by faith
I
that I am saved today.
By
in Jesus' name I
I'm
pray.
Saved.
Amen.
Amen and amen. So those of you who are watching, if you did that prayer, just write us, let us know, you know, that you have accepted Jesus as your personal Savior. Thank you, Bishop Johnson. We thank God because we can come and we can bring a positive message. So remember, do not let your talent go to waste. Don't bury it, but keep working. Go ahead, Bishop. Give your last thought real quick.
I just want to say to everyone that's listening, we are just so excited to be on this program.
Amen.
To help give out the word of God.
Amen.
I'll say it like that.
Amen.
Give out the word of God that you may get to know Him.
Yes.
And you may get to know that He is a loving God.
Yes, Lord.
And that He has your best interest,
yes,
at heart. Amen.
Amen. So those of you watching, tune in to us next month, you know, in the mix. Like I said, you can don't switch your channel. We are on the air. There's different programming today. We continue to come. This is your host, Dr. Swabe, Bishop Johnson, especially from Kansas City, Johnson. We thank you, Bishop, for being here with us. And we pray that this month will continue to be a success as we come next month.